she's the California Public Utilities Commission and an official oil, gas, and geothermal resources to accelerate the permanent closure plan. What are your thoughts on closing it? What is the timeline look like?
And how will you, give me feedback? how will you give the community feedback? But what does your timeline look like? We'll start with this off.
Right. So from timeline-wise, there is no reason not closing it right now. The past 2 years, it had barely any withdrawal. So this threat that you're going to have blackout and all that is all facade. The unfortunate fact is, when we're close to the voting and all that, all of a sudden we have the politicians coming with this melody, yes, we will support you, yes, this letter to the commissioner. There is no need for delay. It can be closed. I'm as an engineer. I have the data available to support whatever engineering programs we can implement. We have been testing since 2006. When I say we, as a team between DWP, the Bureau of Street Planning where I work, we're having a lot of solar panels installed in Porter Ranch and citywide. There is some on Ventura Boulevard close to Valley Circle. There is about 100 on Cessnan, where Porter Ranch Drive is, Corbin all the way to YMCA. I have live data to support. We can do a lot of programs. Also, I've been, while working with the sidewalk repair, implementing and testing on sidewalks that when you step on it, generate power. We tried through Porter Ranch Landscape Committee to get it into the vineyard, however, we failed. Yes, we can close it. It's not a political, it's not an engineering issue. It's a political issue. You know, everybody coming with a horn and saying, oh, once we are elected, we will close it. The timeline should be is, if the term ends December 13th and I am elected, by Christmas, it's done, and that will be the Christmas present to the
Shoreman.
11 days for me is more than enough in office to close it.
Yeah.